Hey, welcome to the first part of the Google Ads Crash Course series. My name's Josiah and I'll be taking you through your first search campaign. Now, the reason for this video is that a lot of business owners may come to me and in my agency and not be able to afford our retainers and budgets and things like that. So this is mainly for business owners who are like solopreneurs and also marketing managers who don't have the budget to afford a marketing team. What I'm going to do today, and the reason for this is because a lot of marketing agencies, a lot of businesses out there misspend a lot of their ad budget. So for example, there's a few, like you can go through all the studies yourself, 12.5% here of paid search budgets go to irrelevant search terms. So a lot of ad wastage going on across many different companies out there. And likewise, if you go through some other reports, according to marketers themselves on their teams, they're misspending their budgets up to 20 to 40 to 60%. I'm not sure if this 80% or even the 60% is true. If that is true, then I'm sure those marketing teams aren't really doing the right job. But anyway, let's go through your first ad campaign. So we're going to take an example for a local dentist, right? And it doesn't matter if this is a local dentist, like service-based or a product-based business. Product-based businesses slightly have a different campaign setup, but the methodologies are the same. We follow a methodology called SIAG or S-I-A-G, which means single intent ad group. So single intent ad groups are basically trying to create an ad campaign based on the intent of the person on the other side of the screen. They're typing in something and you've got to make your educated guess based on experience in the industry, based on what you think it means that they're typing in that certain keyword. And you're trying to take an educated guess based on that to enter in specific auctions that you want to bid for and intercept that traffic. I'll break that down what that means in a simpler way. But first, let's get into our first campaign. So this example here, we're going to set up a campaign for Invisalign. So it's a dental service for Invisalign to straighten teeth and get a better smile and all that kind of stuff. So let's go into the ad campaign and we're going to click on create and then click on campaign. So you'll come across this screen here. And basically, since we're either going for leads or going for sales, in this case, it's leads, we're just going to select that as the campaign objective. There's arguments on both sides in the industry what to go for. I'm not going to be too politically correct in this video. So I'm just going to keep it simple, short and sweet. Just click on leads, because in this case, it's a service business. It's local, they're generating leads. If you're e-com or product based, I'd probably go more sales. It really just depends on your circumstances. So I'm going to assume you've already got your conversion tracking set up already. If you don't, I'll create a separate video for that and my recommendations on the software to use to make conversion tracking so much easier for even local businesses to track your ROI. But in this case, I'm going to just assume you've got conversion tracking set up. So click continue. From here, we're just running a simple search campaign. We're not going to go any overboard or too fancy. So we're just going to click on search. And really the whole purpose here is website visits. Okay, so we're trying to send people to this URL. So we're going to click on here. And then what I like to do with the campaign setup is organize it by location. So for example, you could have one location like Melbourne, and you can have ads inside of that for different services. So you might have Invisalign separated by sleep dentistry, separated by teeth whitening. So those would be in their respective categories or what we call ad groups to separate them so that you don't have a really messy account. You try to keep it organized. So what I would do is have like Melbourne, because this dentist might want to venture into different cities or different suburbs and split test that and the results, but there are easy ways to do that. Again, for simplicity's sake, I'm going to keep it simple. So for the campaign name, we're going to also add the intent or the funnel type. So without being too complicated, we're trying to find people that need this service, Invisalign. They're looking for the service right now and they're ready to take that next step into a first smile consultation or something like that. And so in marketing, we call that bottom of funnel. That's at the very bottom of the funnel. People are kind of ready to take that next step. They're looking for different service providers, etc. So we're just going to call this bottom of funnel. And that's the acronym for that. Okay, but we also, so we won't put Invisalign in there because we might have different ad groups, one for Invisalign after this and white teeth whitening, et cetera. Click continue. And then in here, you've got your bidding strategy. So this campaign, this account has already like been running for quite some time and it's come up with a suggested bidding target cost per acquisition, TCPA. But what we're going to do is not add that for the sake of you've got a new account, right? And let's say that you've got your conversions set up. It's going to recommend that you have your conversions set up in the back end and bid for conversions instead of bidding for, say, clicks. Do not bid for clicks. I don't recommend it. There are in some cases in the past where you might not see results in the first like month doing conversions. And then you might want to switch it to clicks just to collect data for a week or two, just to collect the amount of people coming through and then switch it to conversions. That's been a known strategy. Really, it's a case-by-case basis, I think. But nowadays, I just use conversions. So let's go conversions. We're going to click next. And then here you've got search network and display network. Now, this is a funny thing because Google just wants to basically say, oh, we're not spending all of your budget. Like there's not enough people searching for Invisalign in Melbourne. And this month you've only spent like 40% of your budget, right? How about we spend that extra 60% on across these other networks and we don't know how it's going to go. You're potentially going to waste that 60%. And in my opinion, in my experience, this has been the case always. So I do not click these, just uncheck those, right? For the location, we're going to select, obviously, Melbourne is the desired location, but you might want to also target surrounds. So I only really want to target people who live in this targeted location. So I don't want to really show up for people who show interest in this location because you could be getting someone who lives somewhere else or, you know, they're always typing in Melbourne or it's a bot or something like that. I don't really want those. So I'm just going to select regularly lives in the target location or they're in there. So here we're going to keep this default. To keep things simple, we're going to say no for the automatically generated assets. Down here, you're going to keep this practically all as default, right? This is a new one optimized for conversions. But for the rest of it, let's just click next, okay? Now, with this, with the keywords, I'm actually going to stop here and go into the next video, which is quite important for keyword research. That's part two. I'll see you there. Thanks.